Actually, the beer was me. Summer beer is coming. I'm ready for it.
Excellent. All right, so I'm going to play maybe a few more games and then hand over the stream to somebody else.
I guess I'll have to thank her for that. Although, who am I going to play that against?
Right?
Yeah, it certainly does. Mm-hmm. Sound check. Okay. Probably just my browser. Yeah, we went for a Scotch opening here, and white played e5, so that's how we got to this position. I could play it back over for you. So this is how we got here. I'm not sure how good or bad that is, but I'm up two pawns. I can win this. I'm up one pawn, maybe I can win this. Yeah, the stream is still here, but I am starting to look for somebody to hand it off to. So, let me know if you might be interested. And writing a string trio. Oh, very cool. So, would anybody care to play chess next, or should I just let this tournament end my stream? Okay. Dude, I was down like 5 seconds. No, I'm sorry, I had 5 seconds left, and you're asking me what happened. What happened is with 5 seconds, I let him promote. So here's the eval graph. He's winning, 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 winning. And finally, we equalize here. So after 30 moves, I finally got ganged up on this pawn here. After some inaccuracies on his part, I actually won the pawn. Picked up a second pawn. And all is good here. But, yeah, the reality is that with like 5 seconds on my clock, I couldn't hold the position. And I've been playing for a number of hours anyway. So, yeah, that's where we ended up. Huh. Apparently, the way I played this endgame was quite solid until the very end. So knight h6, and instead of just taking... Oh! I had queen h2 here. I could have just taken the pawn also. Like, every move wins other than the move I played. But, I don't know. I think it was an okay game. I thought it was actually a good game. He got a really sizable lead in the opening because I played this nonsense that I don't know. I played g6 when I'm pretty sure something else is the book move, but I don't know what. So I played g6. This is a pretty typical kind of situation for me where I haven't lost any material, but right out of the opening, I'm effectively down a point. And apparently knight b5 doesn't make that any better. So by this point, it's looking pretty damn hopeless. And so I just try to pull things together. Queen b8's inaccurate, queen f6 is okay. I consider queen f6. I thought that after bishop g5, my queen was trapped, but that's not the case. Yeah, queen f6 was the better move here. It's bishop f6, bishop g7, f6 is bad, I should just trade bishops, but I doubt that. I mean, how bad can queen d5 be? Yeah, this position is pretty crazy. Best move is queen c8. What does that mean? Why would queen c8 be any good here? Yeah. I did okay in the middle game to end game transition. But had white played reasonable moves? I don't know, like here white's effectively up 2 points. I haven't done anything too clever in this middle game. I just developed my pieces. But had white played well, I would have been just completely wiped off the board. Fortunately for me, white isn't looking for moves like knight takes e5, which wins material because of the knight f7 check thing, because the bishop is hanging. He's also not looking for moves like f4, which get all his pieces into the action while half my pieces are still in the corner. So, I mean, it's fortunate for me that my opponent just figured that he's... I don't know, my opponent got overconfident. That's what happened. And fortunately for me, I was able to trade the bishops, and suddenly I'm hanging in there. H5 seemed as reasonable as anything. A6, I'm trying to play B5. And here... Oh, I thought knight E7 was crushing. So, maybe knight E7 isn't as crushing as I thought it was. Yeah, so if white plays just actively, if he tries to blast open the F file and make use of his D file, I'm just not in a great place here. So this is kind of what should have happened, and what really didn't happen. But I felt that with my queen and my rook in the corridor, with him dominating the center, this would be pretty bad for me. Fortunately, he played a pretty passive move, allowed me to plug up the d file, and then pile everything on top of the d pawn. So I played some resourceful moves, but I wouldn't say that I played well overall. Yeah, it wasn't a case of me playing exceptionally well. It was just I played some kind of resourceful moves and happened to outplay my opponent, but it wasn't any magic that I did. Looking like this Pressa guy's got quite a challenge here. Uh-oh. Oh, white blew it. No, I mean, Fianchetto's totally right. I was being as blunt and saying pretty much the same thing, so it's okay to be honest. I mean, how else are you going to improve if you're not honest? But yeah, if anybody wants to take over and do some chess streaming, that'd be fun. I'd be glad to join you or at least watch your channel. I'm going to take a break, so or I'm going to wrap this up rather. So thanks to everybody for watching. Hope to see you again sometime. Sorry to catch you at a bad time if you're not able to watch it live, but I will highlight these, so keep a lookout for that too. All right, well, thanks for watching. I'm going to wrap this up. Have a good night.